Welcome everyone, I'm Marco Zuppone, I'm a Sentinel trainer based in Cambridge, UK, and in this short video I will show you the basics of Sentinel LDK EMS. EMS stands for Entitlement Management System, and as the name suggests, it is an application that helps you to take control over the full licensing lifecycle of your software. EMS is a web-based application powered by Tomcat that normally is installed on a server to guarantee continuous availability, but it is even possible for demonstration and test purposes to install it on a simple workstation. The users can access EMS from their client machines using a web browser. EMS is not only for the internal users, but you can even decide to expose EMS to your end users to perform license activations and updates. EMS is a role-based application. The EMS administrator can assign to the internal users different roles to determine the function that the users are authorized to perform in Sentinel EMS. This is, in a nutshell, the basic workflow to create a product from scratch and generate a license for it. The first step is to define at least one feature to assign to your product. The feature is the smallest licensable part of your application. If your application is, for example, a CAD application that is able to do 2D drawing and 3D drawings, and you want to sell the feature separately, then you can create two distinct features, one for the 2D drawing functionality and the other for the 3D drawing one. The second step then is to associate the features to one product. After defining the product, we need to create at least one entitlement for that product. The entitlement represents the order from our virtual shelf for the product. It's called entitlement because it entitles the end user to get the license. An entitlement can contain more than one product at a time, but in this video we will keep it simple, and so my entitlement will contain one product only. The last step is to consume the entitlement, burning an hardware key or creating a software key. In this video, I will demonstrate how to burn an hardware key to be dispatched to an end user. And now let's see in practice how to go through this workflow in EMS. On this lab, I performed an express installation of Sentinel LDK and I installed all the components. So EMS and all the other components are on the same computer. I prepared on the desktop an application that I protected using envelope with the feature ID 123. So if we try to run it now, it will fail because it's not able to find any key with the feature ID 123. How can I access EMS? There are a couple of ways. The first one is through the Sentinel LDK vendor suite. I open the Sentinel LDK vendor suite and I click on EMS. The other way is to open my favorite browser and to browse to the address of the instance of my EMS server. In this case, I will use the Sentinel vendor suite app and I click on EMS. And I need to enter the username and password by default out of the box. The default username and password are admin. The first thing that I need to do is to define at least one feature. So I need to go to the catalog. I need to click on features. A very important thing that I need to check is the batch code. I need to be sure that I'm creating the feature under the batch code of my master key. So this is my batch code. I press new feature and I give a symbolic name to my feature. I can call it MSZ feature, for example. The very important thing about the feature is the feature ID. When you log in to find if you have a license. When you log in a license, then you log in using the feature ID, not the symbolic name. So I said my application is protected with feature ID 123. I need to do the same, to put the same number here, feature ID 123, and press save. Then at this point, I need to define a product. I click on products, always check that the batch code is the same, is correct. I press new product, I name it, I call it this one MSZ prod, for example. I press add feature. I select the feature that I want to add, in this case one feature only in this sample. And then I can even configure the terms, the licensing terms of every feature independently, clicking the configure button here. I can set if the license it will be perpetual, if the license will expire in a certain number of days, or after a certain number of executions, if this license can be shared on the network and supporting concurrency or not. In this sample, I will simply create a license perpetual. Another important thing to select when you create a product is the locking type. HL is for hardware keys, but there are other locking types available. You can set it to HL and SL admin mode, so that you give the flexibility to license this product using hardware key and software keys. Or there are other options as well to permit every kind of key: hardware key, software key, admin mode, and software key user mode as well. In this case, I'm interested to license my product using hardware keys only, so I leave it to HL. I can press save as complete because I'm satisfied with the option that I selected. And now I can create the entitlement for my product. So I need to go to entitlements and press new entitlement. In this case, I want to burn a key that is attached to my computer, so I can select hardware key. I need to add the product without my MSZ prod. I can name a customer, so this entitlement will be assigned to a customer. It's not a mandatory step. In this case, I will not do that because it is a short video about that. We are going to produce more videos to go in details on every single option. I'm ready, and so I can press produce. This show that I have a key, dongle hardware key, attached to my computer. If I have more than one, I need to set in which one I want to burn my license. This is the only one. I select this one and I press burn. The burn process was successful. I can close this box. I can even close EMS. The key is still attached to my computer physically. And so now my protected application that needs the feature 123 should work. Let's try. The application works. Now, for the sake of the demonstration, I close it, I remove the key, and I try again. The application does not work because it's not able to find the key anymore. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you find it useful and interesting. Please stay tuned to our channel for other videos. Thank you and have a nice day.